Nule taga mister, kabladha masai zekame na kuwa ni masaka. Wakisorora nisho moka but awana clue. Kila teni vitazamdomo ati wana chapatizi EPL wakati is the blues. Sayenye kwa mic now for church na kabla manze kulala nishako na guna msewa ma blues.
Want to go abroad. It's a lot to learn. I say by all means, go. You know, I'll be honest, to appreciate what you have back home, you have to step out for a minute and say, yes, I really now see the value, the opportunities that lie in this country. Because as long as you have the skills, the experience, the burning desire to get out of your comfort zone, being impatient to make things move, I always say, be impatient in your career. You know, I want to get here, and I want to get here like yesterday. It'll go very far. Me standing in front of you is a big honor, it's a big pride, because in you, I see the next leaders, I see the next corporate executives, and I don't see them here. I see them in New York, I see you in Paris, I see you in Canberra, I see you in Tokyo, I see you in Nairobi. One word. Go out there, get exposed, get the experience, and apply all that knowledge, all those skills, all the experience back home. Because I can tell you this for free. If you're going to look at opportunities in the world, the last frontier is Africa.
There are so many opportunities with the new technology, and I used a lot of that to do my, like in my workplace and in my schooling, I used a lot of continual learning, even the askaris. You always learn something new from those people, don't derail them. So that continuous learning also helps you to understand who you're dealing with, but strive to learn more than what you have and differentiate yourself. Sometimes you have to understand where there are opportunities and position yourself to excel in that area so that then you're an obvious choice. So I decided to do tourism because at that moment in time, I did a quick analysis and in Africa, there were no tourism schools. And not tourism from the perspective of tour operating and whatnot. No, it was tourism from an economic development point of view. Sustainable development. What is the economic sense behind the tourism sector? Which is coincidentally why I've ended up in the airline industry. But there is some mathematics and some economic sense in tourism. As much as we don't want to understand, personal branding does a lot. So how you present yourself, how you speak, I'm not by any means saying you must twang. Please do not articulate yourself. Articulate yourself well, say what it is you want to say. You being a Kenyan is the only God-given thing that will differentiate you from any other person. Embrace it, accept it, and use it to position yourself.
Okay, Esther, tell me a bit about yourself.
Apart from what you've seen on my CV, you've seen that I have a degree in environmental studies. I also have 2 years experience in managerial work because I've managed more than 10 people in my current job.
Okay, very, very interesting. I've looked at your CV and I've read through it, but tell me in your own words, what are your key strengths?
I have managed to work in a most stressing workplace whereby I have to meet deadlines. I've been able to meet deadlines. I also have managerial skills and because I supervise more than 10 people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also very good in coordination and teamwork. because I've worked in different counties in Kenya. I've worked in Eldoret, Nakuru, Nairobi, and in all these areas I've worked with different people, coordinating programs, yeah, and making sure that everything runs according to the program.
So I know them, by the time I'm giving the job, I need to know about them.
People say that I take too long to make decisions, but the reason why I do that is because I gather all the information so that I can be able to make a conclusive decision. I can analyze the information that I have, such that when I'm making that decision, I make sure that I make the right decision.
Okay, yeah, it's actually better to take time than make a decision. Questions for me before we close the interview?
And that you are launching a new product. So how is the update?
We launched the product about a month ago, and after a very good communication campaign, the uptake has been very high. I have been seeing people at the branches queuing to actually sign up to the particular product. So yeah, very good. A lot of people have been coming here for interviews, and one thing I'd like to ask them, do they have any weaknesses? Because every candidate has a weakness, and I need to know that so I can plan for that.
For me, this wish, if I can be able to work alone, because when I'm alone, I can just work very nicely, that's my life. I work from 10 to extend to 4 to 7, because I can mostly work good at evening, rather than morning hours.
Okay, now we've come to the end of the interview. Do you have any questions for me before we part ways?
Yes. What about the salary? How much do you need to pay me?
You need to pay your competitive salary, but yes, it will be matching the standards of the industry. Yeah. Do you have another question for me?
Yeah. Is there any advantage of working with you, like house allowance, my holiday allowance?
Yeah? Yes, we do have that, but only for the directors. But when you work at a particular director, maybe you can qualify for that.
Yeah, that's why I told you, I'm not very happy to be a good one.
Thank you very much. Do you have any other questions?
No.
Okay, thank you for your time. We shall definitely be getting back to you, and I wish you all the best as you continue your project. And what is that you have in this envelope?
No, this is just my personal document.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
I guess, was very knowledgeable already about the organization. But like Dennis, who did not know anything about the organization, she already knew that you have launched a product and you want to start selling it, so that's already a good impression to the person who's doing the interview.
I liked how Esther turned her weaknesses into somewhat strengths and just didn't face them on weaknesses. But I think that she takes a very long time to make a decision, but you realize it's because she's also very analytical and very precise on the amount of work she does. So I think that was a very good thing, that coming from Esther and not Dennis.
What's an opportunity to actually show in my weaknesses I'm a better candidate to have, because I take long to make a decision, but it's because I'm analyzing. As for Dennis, what did he say? He likes to work alone. And teamwork has to be there. Now, the other question we asked was, your strengths. And Dennis here said the usual ones. I'm hardworking, ambitious, kind, compassionate, with the energy to contribute to the organization. You know how many CVs we get like that? Very many. But what Esther did is that she talked about specific strengths that were related to the job, very unique, and she actually connected very well with the person who was interviewing her. Finally, do you have a question for me? Surely, Dennis. Utalipa how much? Bonuses, etc. and you've all gotten the job. Ideally, you should not ask questions about that at that point. In fact, the employee is likely to ask you, what are your salary expectations? Leave it up to the end when you're talking about the salary part, because the salary discussion is not even done in the first interview. Esther definitely had researched about the company, and she even asked a question that was very good, and then when I asked her why she asked that question, she actually had an idea. So please ensure you create a good impression. All these tips, by the way, are on www.mentortoleader.com. For those who would read, you'd actually get a lot of knowledge.
We get confused which courses to pick. And at the end of the day, sometimes after your parents push you, times when you become kichongumu kidogo, you end up being a certain cost, and when you get to the job market, either you don't get a job, or you don't get offers in relation to the cost that you need. It's more of a challenge. I don't know how you'd advise them.
What is the 2030 is talking about? What are the areas that the country is developing towards? And how do you then, your undergrad is your undergrad. You'll meet a lot of people who tell you, I did a BEd, but now I'm in banking.
The opportunity is up there. You need a ladder to get up there. There's some people who have a ladder to reach that goal up there. But there's some people who have to look for that ladder so that they can reach that goal up there.
For me, it's your hunger. Is this person hungry? Do they have ambition? And most of the time I end up taking the local guys. Do they have an analytical mind? Do they see a problem and look at various ways that they can solve that problem? Or do they pass it along to the next person? Or are we always looking for the path of least resistance? Are we ready to get out of our comfort zone?
We have a program with Norwood, the Golden Village. Thereby, we have a next stage program. After every 2 years, they take one lady and one gent. When you live here, you'll be in second year. When you go there, you start fresh. Whatever you did at University of Nairobi, it's past tense, start afresh for 4 years. You are in second year, whatever you covered in your at UN, forget about it, start afresh. But when they come to our class, they'll start from where they left. So I'm like, is it that they don't value our education?
It should not necessarily define your destiny. However, once you've finished that and you feel you need to specialize, pick on areas where you feel have the chance of positioning you well in relation to the future of the country, the future of the continent, so to speak.
How do people outside there view the talent?
When there was a lot of segregation with African Americans, they used to have this song that just said, keep your eyes on the prize. And as long as you keep your eyes on the prize, you will achieve what you're striving for.
You have the new Terminal A and 1E, which is coming up. And you have the new Dreamliners. You have so many interesting things. So I want to capture something about Kenya Airways. And I don't know how to go about it, how to approach the management.
Yourself that you need to come to us and challenge and say, my studies has shown that for the past how many donkey years we've been independent, we are just still selling that. So I challenge you, let your thesis be on some of the new products that you think the country should take up.
The minute you walk out of here, pay attention to your environment. And from there you start sniffing out the problems and coming up with innovative solutions to those problems. And from there, you're also on the road to being financially stable. But all these things start from, stage one.
Now, we'll...